So in this session we are going to learn about installing NiFi cluster on Linux servers. So in this session I have three Linux servers. First server is called NiFi01. This is the host name of the server, and second server is NiFi02, and the third server is NiFi03. So first thing you need to make sure that you are able to ping all the servers with the host name. So if I do ping NiFi02, I should be able to get the response. However, in this case I do not get the response. The reason being is that IP address and host names are not updated in etc hosts file. This action is typically taken care by Linux administrator. So in your production environment you need to make a request with Linux administrator, and he is the one who is going to take care of this activity. Because updating etc hosts file is risky and also it requires root access. So in my case I'm going to switch to root, and then I'll be updating the etc hosts file. So let me switch to root on all the servers. You can do this one by one, you can do it whichever way you like. So basically I need to know IP address of all the machines. So I need to type hostname space hyphen I, and second server also I need to do hostname space hyphen I, and same I need to do on third machine as well. So now I know the IP address of all the servers. So in the first server we need to update IP address and hostname of second and third server. So I'm going to do, okay, let me go back to this server. So this is the first server. So I'm going to do echo and then going to update this IP address here along with the host name. So this IP address is basically NiFi02, and we want to update /etc/hosts file. Okay, so that's it, hit enter, and then I'm also going to update for NiFi03. So here again go type echo, this is the IP address, and this IP address belongs to NiFi03 hostname. Okay, so both of these values updated on server 1. Now we will go to server 2 and we will update IP address and hostname of server 1 and server 3 on server 2. So I will do echo, and we need IP address of server 1, which is this, and this is called NiFi01. And then I need to update for server 3 as well. So I have copied IP address and now I'm going to paste that IP address here. And this server IP address is basically NiFi03. Okay, so we have completed on first and second server. Now on third server we need to update IP address and hostname of first and second server. So I will do echo, and we need to get the IP address of first server, which is this one. And this IP address is called NiFi01. And now we need to update for server 2. So this is the IP address of server 2. And I'm updating it here on server 3, etc hosts file. Okay, so once you've done that, now if I do ping NiFi02 on server 1, then I should be able to ping it. Okay, so you see we are getting the response. Previously we were not getting the response. Now if I do ping space NiFi03, I should be able to ping this server. So similarly from NiFi02, we should be able to ping NiFi01 and also NiFi03. Similarly from server 3, we should be able to ping NiFi01 and we should be able to ping NiFi02. Okay, so you see we are getting the correct response from all the servers. So it means now we are good to start the setup. So let me clear the screen. And also remember, currently we are logged in as root, so I'm going to type exit, so we switch back to non-root user. Okay, so if I type who am I now, so you can see now we are logged in as a user which is called NiFi admin. I have same user created on all the servers. So in production it is a good practice that you have similar user created on all the servers whenever you are forming a NiFi cluster. Now we'll clear the screen. And other thing which we now need to make sure is that we have Java installed on all the three servers. Okay, so I believe you already know the steps to install Java. So in this tutorial, I'm just going to use Package Manager to install Java. However, in your case, if you have a production environment which doesn't have access to the internet, you may need to download JDK and you need to set up JDK home, basically Java home, and then you should be able to run NiFi. So this is a command which is required to install Java, and I'm going to use this. Okay, so on NiFi 01 I already have Java installed, so it just said that it is not able to do anything because it already has latest version of Java. So if I do the same on server 2, server 2 did not have Java already installed, so it is installing Java here. And similarly, we can do the same on server 3. So either you can wait for the progress or you can continue the same on third server. So I'm going to continue the same on third server and hit enter. Now it is installing Java. On second server, if you see, now installation has completed. And third server is prompting for the confirmation, so I'm going to give Y. So whatever we are doing now, these are the prerequisites before you even start installing NiFi cluster. Okay, so now we have Java installed on all the three servers. Let's clear the screen. And now we will type Java space hyphen version. Okay, we will do the same on all the three machines and we should be able to get similar response which I'm getting now. Okay, I typed Java incorrectly. Okay, so we get the same response on all the three servers. So basically we have now Java 8 running on all the three servers. Now I'm going to clear the screen. And currently I'm in the NiFi admin's home directory. So on all the three servers I'm into same directory. Okay. Now we will start downloading NiFi software. And also I'm going to go for the latest version which is available right now. So it is NiFi 1.11.4. So you need to click here and then you are going to get the link. And this is a link which you need to download. So I'm going to right click on the link and select copy link address. And then I'm going to go to each of the server and going to download it using wget command. If you do not have wget command already installed, you are going to get error. If you see on this server, I'm getting error that wget command is not found. So I'm going to install wget first using sudo yum-y install wget. Okay, wget is completed. So now I should be able to run. Okay, let me clear the screen and let me type wget and then the URL which we copied. Okay, so now downloading has started on this server as well. And now we are going to do the same on NiFi node 02. Let's check if we have wget already here or not. So here also we are getting error, which means we do not have wget. So I'm going to install wget first, and then we'll be typing that command to download software. Okay, so on first server and third server downloading has completed, and second server downloading of Apache NiFi is going on. And once we have the software, then we will begin by started making the changes in the configuration files. Okay, so we have now software downloaded on all the servers. We haven't really installed it yet. So let me clear the screen and let's do ls-lrt on all the servers so we can see that software is available. Or you can just do ls. So you can see software has been downloaded on all the servers. Okay, now let's go back to our installation steps. And here if we see, our step 1 is basically updating the hosts file, which we have already done, and now we are able to ping all the servers using their host names. Step number 2 is updating zookeeper.properties file. So zookeeper.properties files are part of the NiFi software which we have downloaded. So I'm going to go to NiFi 01 server, and first thing if you notice is this software is zipped. So first thing we need to uncompress it. So for that I'm going to use tar space zxf and give the path of the compressed file. Hit enter, and then it is going to uncompress it. And same thing we need to do on all the servers. So I'm going to do the same on server 3. So you can copy paste this command. Okay, and on node 1 or server 1, software has already been uncompressed. So now we see there is another directory which has been created, which is called cd-nifi. This is the one which is uncompressed NiFi directory. And now if you want, it is an optional step, if you want you can actually delete this zip file. If you have less space, you can delete the zip file, because from now onward we are not going to use it. So in my case, I'm just going to remove this. Just make sure you uncompress before removing the zip file. Okay, so now let's clear the screen once again and do ls, and we should be able to see similar structure on all the three servers. Now I'm going to perform the operation on first node. So I'm going inside this NiFi directory, and then we have, if we do ls-lrt, you see we have conf directory inside this NiFi base folder. Okay, so inside conf directory we have something called zookeeper.properties. Okay, so let me show you again. So this is the file zookeeper.properties which we are interested in. So I will open it using vi editor. And then we need to scroll down until the end. And in the end you will see a line which is starting with server.1. So we can remove this. We do not need this line. And then we need to update that with these properties. Okay, now to explain you about these properties. So basically here we are saying server.1. And I'm sorry, this is incorrect. So here you need to specify server.2, and this should be server.3. So I will update this article But when we are making changes, we need to give it correctly. So first line is server.1, second is server.2, and third line is server.3. And then we have hostname. So NiFi01 is the hostname of first server, NiFi02 is the hostname of second server, NiFi03 is the hostname of third server. Then we have two ports, 2888 and 3888. These are the ports which are used by Zookeeper to communicate among peers. And then we have 2181, which is the default port for Zookeeper. If you want to know more about Zookeeper and you want to understand in more detail about these ports and how they work, you can follow the Zookeeper Apache documentation. This discusses in more detail about, you know, what are these ports used for and things like that. Okay, so if you are interested in more details, go ahead and read this documentation about Apache Zookeeper. Apache Zookeeper is basically the backbone of setting NiFi cluster. Okay, so now we will copy paste this and I'll go to NiFi server 1, and here in the zookeeper.properties I will paste this line. And remember, in the article currently there is a mistake, so first line is server.1 and second should be server.2 and third is server.3. So these are also called index numbers. So once you've done that, you can save it and exit. Now I'm going to do the same on all the other servers. So let me do it on node 2. Scroll until the end, remove the default line which is server.1. And then also make changes in the server.1 and 2 and 3. Okay, so this should be server1.2.3. And whatever you see here is NiFi01, NiFi02, NiFi03 is our host names. If in your case, you need to update it with the correct host names. Okay, so this should be the host name of your servers. It should not be NiFi01 in your case, until and unless your server is also called NiFi01, NiFi02 and NiFi03. Okay, so I'm going to copy it and then I will just save this and close. And then I'm going to go to node 3, and here also we need to perform the same steps. So I'm going to NiFi directory, then going to conf folder, then I'm going to open zookeeper.properties in VI editor. Now I'm going to move to the last line, and here we can remove whatever is already there, then copy and paste this. Okay, make sure you have server.1, server.2 and server.3 properly configured. So once you do that, you can save it and exit. But before we do that, there is one more thing which we need to notice here is, we don't need to make any changes other than this. However, what we need to notice here is, if you scroll up, you will see we have something called data directory. And in zookeeper.properties file, we have data directory which is set to ./state/zookeeper. Okay, so what Zookeeper expects is, when you are running Zookeeper in a cluster mode, Zookeeper expects that each of the Zookeeper ID or each of the Zookeeper node is basically having one ID. Okay, and that ID is nothing but the indexing which we have specified here. So server.1 should have ID of 1, server.2 should have ID of 2, and server.3 should have ID of 3. And these IDs you need to specify in a file which is called myid file. And that myid file is going to get created in this directory. So that is not going to get created automatically. We have to create it in this directory. Okay. So I will save the configuration here. Just going to cross check again. Everything looks okay. So we can save and exit. Okay. Now we can exit from here. So I'm going to clear this screen first. Okay, and let's see what is the current directory which we are in on all the three nodes. Okay, so right now we are in the conf directory, so we need to go one level back. Here also we will go one level back, and third node also we will go one level back. Okay, let's see which current directory we are in. So this is the base directory where we need to be in. Okay, and once we are in the base directory, we need to create these two directories. We need to create state and zookeeper directory. So I'm going to use mkdir-p command. Okay, so basically we need to remove a slash from here. So it should be just, either you can give dot slash or you just take out dot slash. Okay, so the above command was incorrect, so this should be working. Okay, so what it did was it created a directory which is called state, and inside that it created another directory which is called zookeeper. So you can verify that by using ls command. If you do ls, you should be now able to see another directory which is called state, as you can see here. And if you go inside state, you should be able to see another directory which is called zookeeper. Okay, so I'm going to go back. Okay, and now we need to perform the same steps on all the other nodes. So here also I will perform the same steps, and also on node 3 I will perform the same step. Okay, so now we have state and zookeeper created, directories created at the right place, and now we need my ID file to be created. Okay, so just to refer to this article, so we have done the step number 2, and now we are at the step number 3. Okay, so we have created dot slash state slash zookeeper directory, and now we need to create a my ID file. So let me go to node 1, server 1. Okay, so here when we are creating a file, we also need to specify one index number on each of the file. And on node 1, that index number should be 1. On node 2, that index number should be 2. And on node 3, that index number should be 3. So I will use echo command. But before that, let me show you my current working directory. So I'm still at the same path. So I'm going to use echo, and then we will use dot slash state slash zookeeper, and just make sure here you type echo 1, and then you give redirection, and then you need to use dot slash state slash zookeeper slash my ID. So what this command basically is going to do is it is going to create a new file my ID inside state slash zookeeper directory, and then it is going to write value of 1 inside that file. Okay, so hit enter, and if you want to verify, you can use cat command and give this full path name, and you should be able to see the value which you have just entered. If you want to do this in VI editor, you can do that using VI editor. Now I need to do the same on server 2. However, just make sure you update the value to number 2. Okay, so because this is index number 2. And on the node 3, we need to perform the same. Just need to change the value to 3. Okay, so now we have correctly updated the value of my ID. Let me verify the same using cat command, because this is a very important step. If this doesn't work properly, then you are going to get error when cluster is starting. Okay, so here you see value of 1. On the server 2, you see value of 2 in the my ID file. On server 3, my ID file is having value of 3. So this step is done. Now we are going to move on to modifying NiFi.properties file. So NiFi.properties file is located inside conf directory. So I'm going to node 1. Inside here, if you see, currently I'm in NiFi directory, and now I'm going to go to conf directory, and here we have file which is called nifi.properties. So I'm going to open this file in VI editor, and then we need to modify all the values which are shown here. So we need to modify nifi.cluster is not to true. So I will search with a keyword called cluster. So if you find it hard to update the values using a VI editor, you can use any other editor to edit the values. Okay, let me open it on full screen mode so we can see it properly. Okay, so nifi.cluster is not by default is set to false. That's why when you run nifi by default, it doesn't run in a cluster mode. So here I'm going to set it to true. And in nifi cluster node address, you need to give the host name of this server. So it is nifi01. And the port in the nifi node protocol port, you can give any available port. So in my case, I'm going to give 9991. Okay, then the other thing which we need to change is NiFi cluster node load balance port, and this is set to 6342. So by default, if you see, the value is already set to 6342, so we do not need to make any changes here until and unless you want to change this port from default to any other port. So in this case, we are good. We don't need to make any changes. However, I'm going to change the hostname to nifi01, which is the hostname of this server. Now we need to make changes in nifi remote input host. And here we need to provide nifi01. So what this nifi remote input host is, basically now each of these nodes are going to communicate, send or receive data, you know, from each other, and nifi instances are going to use site-to-site protocol to connect to each other and send the data. Okay, and the port which is going to be used for that communication is the port which we are going to define here. And the hostname is the one which we are defining here. Okay, so here basically we are telling if any other node wants to connect to this node using site-to-site property, he needs to connect at this hostname and at this port. Okay, so port I'm going to specify to 10,000. Again, it can be any port. Just make sure that whatever port you give here, it is not being used by any other application. That port should be available. So we have done until here. Now the other thing which we need to set here is the NiFi web HTTP host. So basically this property is going to affect your user interface URL. So when you are accessing NiFi URL, whatever value you give here, you need to use that as a host name to access the URL. So I will show you when we are accessing the URL. So let me make this change. I'm going to search with this property, and then we can modify it to nifi01. Okay, since this is server01, and server01 is having basically hostname of nifi01. So when I'm saying server01, basically this is our first server. Okay, so whatever changes we have made until now, that we have made on first server. Now we are good, we can save and exit from here. And now I'm going to go to server 2 and going to maximize this. And currently we are in this directory, so I need to move on to conf directory. And inside this I need to open nifi.properties file. Here again we need to make similar changes. Only difference is we need to give here hostname of nifi02 because this is our server 2. Again, in your case, just make sure whatever your host name is called, whatever your second host name is called, you give that host name here. Do not give NiFi02. Okay, you need to give the correct host name. So I'm setting it to true, and NiFi cluster node address I'm setting it to NiFi 02, and port we can set to 9991. And then we have this node load balancer port, which is by default already set to 6342, so we do not need to make any change there. However, we do need to change the host name. So this is the property, port is already 6342, you see here, and we need to change the host name. So this is going to be NiFi02, and then we need to change NiFi.remote.inputSecure to false. I think by default it will already be false. Let's check again. Yes, by default it is already false. We also need to change NiFi.remote.inputHostName, so it is going to be NiFi02. And NiFi.remote.inputSocket port is going to be 10,000. And then we have NiFi Web HTTP host. Okay, so this one on second server is also going to be host name, which is NiFi02. Guys, when you are making changes related to properties file, be very careful, because whatever changes you make here is going to impact how NiFi works. And if you are not sure, just take a backup before you make any changes. Okay, so we have set correct configuration on second NiFi.properties as well. Now we are going to make changes on the third node. So let me go to server 3, which is this server, and let's also maximize this. And currently we are into this directory. I'm going to move to conf directory. Then here we have NiFi.properties. And inside this we need to make the changes which are mentioned here. So first we are setting NiFi cluster is node to true. So that is going to tell that this node is basically part of the cluster. If we don't set it to true, this node is going to be started as standalone. Then second option is NiFi cluster node address. So it tells what is the host name of this node. So it is NiFi03. And what is the port? So by default, if you remember, we are giving port 9991. So I'm going to keep same port here as well. And then we need to change this cluster load balance host to NiFi03. And port is already specified to 6342. So that's fine. And now we are going to go ahead with NiFi remote input host. And here we need to specify NiFi03, and port is going to be 10,000. And then we need to specify NiFi web HTTP host. And this should be the host name, which is going to be NiFi03. Okay, so we have done the configuration on all the three nodes. Now we are good to start all the servers. Okay, so on all the servers I'm going to start NiFi one by one, and also we will see how the response is. So I'm going to NiFi node 1, so you can see the host name is NiFi01, and let me clear the screen. Currently we are into conf directory, so I'm going to go one level back, and if we do ls we should be able to see bin directory. So if we go inside bin directory and do ls, we have something called NiFi.sh script. So this is the script which we need to run, and we need to specify start, and also I'm going to give ampersand here, so this starts as a background service. Okay, so it is running in background. If you want to see the logs, you can go to, currently we are in the bin directory, so you need to go one level back and then you should be able to see logs directory. So here you go inside logs directory, and if you do ls, you will have nifi-app.log. Okay, so this one I'm going to open using tail-f and this log file name. So tail-f, what it will do is it will keep on showing us this file. If there is any changes made in the file, it is going to keep us showing those updated changes. Okay, so right now we see that basically this server is trying to start, and also it is, yeah, so basically it is trying to start. Now let's do the same on node 2 and node 3. Let's start NiFi. So I'm going to go to bin directory, and here we have nifi.sh. And then I'm going to do the same on third server. Okay, currently we are here. Now I'm going to go to bin directory, and here we have nifi.sh. If you want to see the logs, you can go one level back. And here you should have, one sec. Okay, here you should have logs. So inside that you should have nifi-app.log. Okay. So now we see all the instances are trying to start. And when they are starting, let's see what is the logs we see. Okay, so until now we do not see anything related to cluster. These are just the typical message you will see when you are starting NiFi on a non-cluster mode as well. So I'm looking for the lines which is talking about cluster and also heartbeats. Okay, that is how we know that NiFi is trying to start cluster services in a, basically in a cluster mode. Okay, so here I'm getting the error that nifi.zookeeper.connect string is not set. So it seems like we missed setting this value here. So in that case, I have to stop NiFi. So we are going to go to bin directory and let's run nifi.sh. Okay, and stop it. Okay, it says NiFi is not running, so because NiFi couldn't start properly, so anyways it is down. And now we need to go back to conf directory, and here we need to go to nifi.properties. And here we need to verify that this property, okay, this NiFi state management embedded property was set on all the nodes properly or not. So I'm going to go to node 2. One second, yeah, we were here on node 3, so let's first check here. Okay, so yeah, here it was set to actually false, so we actually missed to change it to true. And the other thing which we missed is putting this connection string. Okay, so you saw from the error message we were able to identify what is the error, and we saw that the error was related to this property not being set. So if you miss anything, you are going to get errors which you may need to troubleshoot based on the error message which you see. So in this case on server 3 I have set this property, and I think we had made the same mistake on server 2 as well. So let me do nifi-sh stop. And anyways, it is saying NiFi was not running. So yeah, probably we were having the same issues here as well. So I'm going to go to conf directory and going to open NiFi.properties. And then we need to make sure we have the correct properties updated. So I'm searching with this property name in properties file. And here you see we have not set it. Okay, so we forgot to set it, and that's why we were getting errors. Again here, remember this is hostname, so wherever you see NiFi01, basically that is the hostname of your first server. Wherever you see NiFi02, that is the hostname of your second server. Wherever you see NiFi03, that is the hostname of third server. So in your production environment, please set up the correct hostnames. Do not just copy paste NiFi01. Okay, now let's go to node 1 as well. Let's cross verify here also. Okay, right now we are in logs directory, so I'm going to go back to bin directory and we will stop NiFi. Yeah, so it is saying here also NiFi was not running. Now I'm going to go to conf directory and we will open NiFi.properties. And here again we need to verify that this property was set correctly. Okay, so this was supposed to be true, we had missed out, and the connection string was supposed to be given, which we also missed out. So whenever you are installing in production, just make sure you have a list of settings which you need to do, so you can plan the settings and you do not miss out, because there are really around 10 to 12 properties which we need to change on each of the properties file. So now we are going to go back to bin directory and then we will start NiFi again. I will do the same on all the nodes. Okay, and then we can start verifying on one of the nodes. Let's start checking the logs. So probably on this node I will go to logs directory and then we will do tail-f nifi-app.log and let's see what is the error we get this time, or do we really get the error, or does it going to work properly. Okay, so yeah, this time we see error messages, or not the error messages, it is the log messages which are related to quorum properties and cluster and things like that. So it looks like NiFi is going to start in a cluster mode and it is going to start properly. So here you see stuff related to heartbeat, you see messages related to heartbeat, related to controllers, cluster coordinator, cluster election. So these are the logs which are telling you basically that NiFi is trying to start in a cluster mode, and also it is trying to connect to all the nodes. Now we see here Zookeeper is also starting voting process and other leader election process. So all these things are Zookeeper's internal work which is taken care by Zookeeper. If you want to understand more about Zookeeper process, you can refer to Apache documentation. Okay, so now let me go to the browser and let me see if we are able to access one of the nodes. So I will type NiFi01 and we know our NiFi 01 we had set port name 8080. Alright, yeah, it seems to be it is working. So let's refresh, or if you do not refresh after 5 seconds, it's going to redirect to /NiFi. Okay, so it is saying flow controller is initializing the data flow. So I think it is going to start up in a cluster mode. It is still taking time. All of the, you know, there is a lot of internal process which needs to be taken care of. So those things are going on. And here we can do the same on NiFi 02. And we can do the same on NiFi 03. And let's keep monitoring these URLs. When you are starting it cluster services for the first time, it can take from 5 minutes to 10 minutes. And you can keep monitoring the logs to know the current status. So here if I see the logs, it is saying cluster is still voting on which flow is the correct flow for the cluster. So let's see the logs here, and once we see that logs looks okay, then we are going to go back to browser and then we will refresh and we will see whether NiFi cluster is coming up. And meantime, if you want, you can also verify the logs on some other servers. So now I'm going to NiFi node 3, and here I'm going to go to logs directory, and we will do tail-f nifi-app.log. And here also we see similar messages. So right now all the three nodes are trying to connect to each other, and there is going to be a cluster coordinator decided, and all the other nodes needs to be sending heartbeats to that cluster coordinator. So you see those processes going on. Also here it is showing the time which it is going to take. Okay, so it is, you see the time is decreasing here. This is the time which is going to be taken for basically cluster coordinator election. Meantime, let me try refreshing this browser and let's see what we get now. So until now we are getting the same message. Okay, so what that means is that this process is still going on. Okay, right now we see process seems to be finished and it is saying web services has started. Okay, this is for node 3 right now because we are on node 3. Now let's see on the other server. So here also we see similar messages, and here it is saying services started. So I think now it should be okay. Now let's go back to these nodes and refresh them. Alright, great. So now cluster is set up properly, and we can see we have a new icon which is a cluster icon showing here, and it is showing that there are three nodes connected and total node is supposed to be three nodes. So we have three out of three nodes successfully connected. And also on the right side, if you go to global menu, here you should be able to see one extra option which is called cluster. And if you click on cluster, Here you can see all the nodes. Okay. And if I go to system, I can see what is the processes which is running on each of the system, how many total threads which are running. And inside JVM, we should be able to check the heap size. We can see the heap utilization. We can see non-heap utilization. Similarly, we can see how much storage is available, how much is the used space and free space on each of the servers. So we can see NiFi01 server is a bit more utilized, because probably that server, I already had some other stuff stored. So that's why that server is showing more utilized in terms of file space utilization. So if you remember, we had flow file provenance, we have content provenance, and we have provenance repository. Okay, these are the repository which we had, which are critical ones. So it is always showing what is the space available in those mount points. So this is very important things to manage. And also here we can see the version number of the operating system on which your each NiFi cluster or each NiFi node is running basically. So that's it about setting up a cluster, NiFi cluster on Linux machine. So just a quick recap. So first thing which we had done was we had put host file entry. So we had put IP address and host name on each of the servers. And then here we had specified zookeeper.properties. We had provided server.1 and the host name along with the ports. And next entry was server.2 and the third entry was server.3. So in the article it was incorrect. So we changed it correctly in the zookeeper.properties file. And then we created a MyID file inside NiFi's base directory. We created a directory called state. Inside that we created a directory called state. Inside that we created a file which is called MyID file. And then we set the correct value, correct index value of MyID on all the three servers. So we set the value of 1, 2 and 3 on server 1, 2 and 3 respectively. Then we actually missed this step which was supposed to be done. Okay, so we missed this step, but we went on to configure all the remaining things on node 1, 2 and 3. And then when we started NiFi cluster, we got the error, and that error was basically saying that we haven't set this property nifi.zookeeper.connect string. So that's where we got the clue when we checked the log file that we have missed this. And then we came back here, we updated nifi.properties file with these correct entries. And after that, when we started NiFi cluster or NiFi services, you can call on each of the nodes. And then we could see that NiFi cluster is up and running, and we were able to connect to NiFi cluster. Now a quick thing is we can just create a small workflow. So I'm just going to use generate flow file. So you will see once we add a processor here, it automatically gets added on all the other places as well. It has already been added. The only reason you are not seeing here is because it is not refreshed, because NiFi user interface gets refreshed every 30 seconds. However, if you refresh here manually, you are going to see that new processor. Okay, similarly here on NiFi node 3, we already see new processor coming. So now it doesn't matter whether I access NiFi user interface from node 3 URL, node 2 URL or node 1 URL. Whatever changes or whatever configuration you do, it is going to be centrally, because now it is working as part of the cluster. So now let's say I'm going to this URL, NiFi03 URL, and here if I update the name of this processor to, let's say, generate dummy data, and if I click on apply, and if I go to any other interface, and if I just right click here, click refresh, you can see that these names are automatically updated. Okay, so this is how basically cluster works. In subsequent sessions, we are going to create some flow, and we will see how those flows work on cluster.